Today we are going to discuss liabilities of company secretary. Liabilities of company secretary is divided into two groups, statutory liabilities and contractual liabilities. Statutory liabilities. So what is statutory liability? Statutory liability means compulsory liabilities, so which is given under the Companies Act. So while discharging the duty as a secretary, so the secretary must ensure that all the provisions what are provided in the Companies Act, so he should agree with it. And if he fails to agree, he become liable to penalty or it may be imprisonment. So it is depending upon the height of default. The first point says failure to file written of allotment. Written of allotment means the statement that should be submitted to the registrar, which contains the name and address of the shareholders and how much shares they are going to hold. So written of allotment, this should be signed by the director or the secretary and it should be filed with the registrar of the company. So when they are going to file that? So they are going to file within 30 days of allotment, and within 30 days of allotment if he fails to file it, so the fine will be up to 5000 rupees every day. The next point says failure to maintain register of members with the registrar. Register of member means the record of individual or individual shareholders who are going to own the company and the detail of the shares what they are going to hold. This register should be or should include the information like name of members, the amount what they are going to pay for the share, when they have holded or the date of holding. If they fail to maintain this register, the fine is 500 every day. The next point is failure to maintain register of directors. So register of director is nothing but a list of director. So usually in the meeting, shareholders are going to elect the directors. So it will be recorded in the minute book. So generally it is stored in the company's minute book. So this list is required to be kept up to date. So why they are going to keep it up to date? Because suppose you want to remove the directors, or suppose the directors are going to resign, so at that time it will be very helpful. So the fine will be up to 500 every day if you are not going to maintain such records. The next is failure to maintain minutes of board and general meeting. So if you are not going to maintain the minute book, so it is a duty of the secretary to maintain the minute book. And if you are not going to maintain it, the fine will be up to 500. So it is compulsory that you have to maintain the minute book. The next is failure to file 3 copies of balance sheet and profit and loss account with the registrar. So after the balance sheet and profit and loss account have been laid before the company at the annual general meeting, so within 30 days of the date of balance sheet laid or where the AGM or annual general meeting of the company is held, you have to file it. So if you are not going to file it, the fine will be 500 every day. The next point is fail to maintain register of charges. So what is this register of charges? So the record of money. Here charges means the money what is borrowed and owned by the company. Why the company is going to borrow and own the money? So it is because for spending it on the property and the other assets. So this register is kept at the official or company's official address. So the fine is up to rupees 5000 if you fail to do that. The next is default in filing statutory report with the registrar. So what is statutory report? So statutory report is prepared by the board of directors and the same report is forwarded to its shareholders before 21 days of holding meeting, which means at the time of sending the notice itself, notice of the meeting itself, you are going to send this report. So this should be filed with the registrar. So you may ask, what does it contains? So it contains the total number of shares that is allotted and how many shares are fully paid, how many shares are partly paid. Total number of cash received for the shares what you are going to allot. Name, address, occupation of directors of the company and the material information of the contract, it will be there in the statutory report. And this should be forwarded or send it to the shareholders before 21 days of holding meeting. If you fail to do this, so it will be a fine of ₹5,000. The next is default in holding statutory meeting. What is statutory meeting? Statutory meeting means a compulsory meeting. So this meeting will be held only once in the lifetime of company. So we can say the first meeting of shareholders of a public company. So it should be held within a period not less than 1 month nor more than 6 months from the date at which the company is entitled to commence the business. So if you fail to hold the statutory meeting, fine will be up to ₹5,000. Next, default in maintaining register of directors shareholdings. So what is this directors shareholding? So there is a term called qualification share. So qualification share is nothing but if you want to be the directors of the company, you should purchase some shares which is called as qualification share. So whatever shareholdings the directors are holding, so that register you have to maintain. Otherwise, the fine will be up to ₹50,000. Failure to hold annual general meeting. So annual general meeting should be held annually or once in the year. Suppose you fail to hold annual general meeting, fine will be up to ₹50,000. Further, the fine will be up to ₹2,500 per day if the default continues. Then the next part is your contractual liabilities. So contractual liabilities of company secretary. So these liabilities arises out his contract of service with the company. The first is act as per the order of directors. So why he should act as per the order of directors? We have studied earlier that secretary is just a servant, right? And it is his duty to carry out all the orders or act as per the orders or the direction given by the director. And in case of breach of contract, so which means when you are going to violate the contract or when you are going to break the contract, so the secretary is liable to compensate the company for any damage. So consequence of breaking the contract, or if you are not going to follow or if you are not going to do the responsibility what is there for you as per the contract, so then the company will be having some damage or loss and it is your liability to compensate those damages. Then the next is exercise a reasonable degree of skill and diligence. So he must exercise a reasonable degree of skill and diligence while discharging his duty. And if he is found to be neglected or negligence, if he is going to neglect, he will be personally liable to make good the losses suffered by the company. So what is this make good the losses? So whatever loss the company is going to suffer, the secretary should make it correct. Then the next is liable for secret profit. So the secretary should not make any secret profit by virtue of his office. If he makes, he has to refund the same with interest. So what is secret profit? So secret profit means, so you are the secretary, so you know what is going on in the company, so you know all the secrets, and using this information, if you are going to make any profit, so you will be liable. The next is liable for acting beyond authority. So what is beyond authority? Authority means power. So beyond authority, we call it as the term called as ultra vires. When you go beyond authority, which whatever given in the Companies Act, Memorandum of Association, Article of Association, so you should follow it. And if you are not going to do that, or if you are going beyond whatever power it is given to you, so you will be liable. The next is liable to pay damages to the company. So secretary is also liable to pay damages to the company for disclosing any confidential information about the company affairs to the outsiders. So if there is any confidential information that the company do not want to share it with the outsiders, so such information is known by the secretary, and using this information, if he is going to disclose such information to the outsiders, so he will be liable. Then the next is liable to third party. So who is third party here? So third party means the outsider. So when you will be liable to the third party, so he will be personally liable to the third party for any fraud communicated by him during the course of his employment. So during the course of his employment, so if he is going to share any information, false information to the outsider, and based on that information, if the outsider is going to act, or the third party is going to act upon it, and if he is going to suffer the loss, so who will be liable? The secretary will be liable.